Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man back with a 4K, Blu-ray, DVD, and VHS update. I added a few new things to the collection in the last couple of days, and here they are. I'll start with the VHS. Nothing major here, but I finally got a copy of Halloween Resurrection on VHS. It was the only Halloween film that was released on VHS that I didn't own, so here it is. I also got a copy of Little Monsters on VHS, which is very cool, since it has different cover art from the two VHS editions that I own. Glad to have this one. On to the DVDs now. Both of these DVDs are unofficial, and I made them myself. I finally added Last House on Dead End Street to my collection. This is a movie I've been wanting in my collection for a long time. I really want that barrel version, you know, the two-disc DVD that was released years ago. Went out of print, and it goes for extremely high prices. Man, I would love to own that one, but it's just so, so pricey. And there is another Burn on Demand disc now available on Amazon, but I figured, you know, why pay for it to be burned on demand when I can burn it on demand myself? So, here it is, Last House on Dead End Street. As far as I'm aware, it is a public domain title now, hence the Burn on Demand feature, so just to clarify that. Next up, I also made myself a copy of Maniac 2, Mr. Robbie. Now, this is available as a special feature on some of the releases of Maniac, but I felt that it deserved its own edition, so here it is. Which brings us to the Blu-rays, and the first one here is the 3-disc limited edition 4K restoration of Maniac. This is an amazing edition of an amazing film, and I'm glad to add this to the collection. I own multiple editions of Maniac, and I had to get this one as well. I could not pass it up. Along with that, I got Joe Spinell in The Undertaker. Now, this is a slasher film I've never seen, but I have been really wanting to see it ever since my buddy Jason from Horrific Nightmares and my buddy Nick the Last Shoegazer reviewed it in one of their About Last Nightmare videos. Next is a Scream Factory Blu-ray, Fender Bender. This is a modern-day slasher film, and I've actually heard some pretty good things about it, so I cannot wait to check it out. And in case you were wondering, it does have reversible artwork, and it's pretty awesome. Here's a Blu-ray I got today cheap on sale while I was picking up something else. It's Big Trouble in Little China. As you can see, it's still in the plastic. I have not opened it up yet. I do own this film on DVD. I believe a few different editions, actually. But I saw this on Blu-ray for a good price and had to add it to the collection. And now for the 4K, and it's actually my very first 4K. You probably guessed it, it's the Best Buy exclusive steelbook of Halloween. In the rare chance that you are somehow confused, this is Halloween 2018. It's the new film. It was just released today on Blu-ray and DVD and 4K, and I really wanted this steelbook. And let me tell you, it took me 4 different Best Buys to find one. I should say it took me 4 different Best Buys to find 2. Because I actually bought 2 copies, one for myself, right here, and one for my son. My son was really excited about this release, so I wasn't gonna settle for the regular Blu-ray edition. I needed this steelbook. So yes, I went to 4 separate Best Buys. The first one had absolutely no copies. The second, absolutely no copies. The third, absolutely no copies. And finally, at the 4th and final Best Buy, they had 3 copies. I bought 2 of them, and one of them was actually sort of mangled. It looks like it was really bent. The spine was sort of sticking out. Don't know what happened to it, but I'm glad I only needed the 2 of them. And, you know, I'm not one of those people who, you know, hoards releases like this. So I don't want you guys to think, you know, I went there and just bought the only 2 that they had in good condition. As I said, my son really wanted this, but I obviously wanted a copy myself. So I bought 2. The crazy thing is, I got to the first Best Buy before it even opened. So I'm not sure why they received no copies. I don't know if it was pre-orders or what, but they literally didn't get any copies in. They had a spot for it, and when I asked the guy, he said they did not have them in the back. You know, we checked the status there, the inventory, and yeah, there were no copies, and he said he wasn't anticipating them getting any. So not really sure why. You know, sometimes they get flooded with steelbooks and other releases, they only get a few. In this case, 3 of my local Best Buy stores had 0. I was lucky though that the 4th store had it, because after that, the closest Best Buy would probably be about an hour to an hour and a half away, and I definitely wouldn't have made it there today. But it all worked out in the end. I have my copy, my son has his most importantly, and we're happy. So, that's it for this update, guys. What do you think? Comment below and let me know. And don't forget, Slashback Saturday is coming up quickly. Be sure to watch and review a slasher remake as part of the Horror Man's Slashback Challenge. Thanks for watching.